Welcome back. Now let's try and solve the question number 4 in the Certified Kubernetes Administrator Killer Shell Simulation. Question number 4, task weight 4%. First, let's use the context and switch to them. Now the question is, do the following in namespace default. Create a single pod named ready if service ready. Let's do that. Kubectl run create a pod named ready if service exists in default namespace. And using this image, which is images nginx 1.16.1-alpine. And then they say configure a liveness probe, which simply runs true. And also configure a readiness probe, which does check if the URL is reachable. You can use this wget command for this. Start the pod and confirm it isn't ready because of the readiness probe. All right. So let's do this. First, liveness and readiness probe. We could not do it right now. Let's grab the YAML configuration using the try run equal to client output as YAML. Let's test it. Now write it to 4.yaml. Let's edit the file. Pod name ready if service exists, right? And the image is this. Now we have to configure the liveness probe, which simply runs a true command. Let's go to the browser and liveness and readiness probe. Let's check for the liveness and readiness probe in the Kubernetes documentation. Open up the first result. You can use Control F to search in the browser. So now we are going to do the liveness probe. So here we have. Let's copy this bit. Come back to the terminal. We don't need any of this. And here you're pasting. So yeah, when you copy paste from the browser anything outside of the terminal, you might see this warning message that it is an unsafe paste. You could just click on the paste button. So they say we have to just execute a command called true. It's not a working command, but yeah, just for the purpose of exam, fine. So liveness probe done. Now we have to get the readiness probe. Now let's search for the readiness probe. Same like liveness probe. Let's give some indentation, paste it. Let's fix the indentation. All right. So they say we have to use this command to see if the service is reachable. So we'll invoke the shell. -c for command. And then we're going to simply paste the command that I have given. start the pod and confirm it isn't ready because of the readiness prop. Because the readiness props is trying to probe this specific service at port number 80. So if the service is not there, it will not schedule the pod. Now let's create the pod. Even before creating, let's make sure there's no pod with the same name there already. Get pods in the default namespace. No pods found. Now let us create it. It says it's created. Now let's check the pod. The status changed running, but it's 0 of 1, so it's not running for some reason. Let's inspect the pod by issuing the kubectl describe. So events, we could clearly see it says readiness probe failed because command, this thing has timed out. So it's trying to probe the service at the port number 80 and it's not able to reach and it timed out. As a reason, it's not able to schedule the pod, even though it's, it says running, it's not fully running. So that's this bit. Now there is one more section that says create a second pod named am I ready. So to create a pod, we use kubectl run. Pod name is this, and we know that we have to do this in the default namespace, of course. And the image that we have to use is nginx 1.16.1 alpine. And they say we have to use the labels. ID equals cross server ID. So if we have to use them in the YAML, we'll use the ID colon format. But since we are using in the kubectl command directly, we have to replace it with ID equals. Yeah, I think that's it. They say the already existing service should now have the second pod as an endpoint. So they say there is a service already with this name. Let's inspect that. Kubectl get service in the default namespace with the service. Am I ready? Yes, it does. Let's also get the endpoints. For now, it says none, and we have not executed this command yet. So we'll execute this command and see if it makes any changes. So it says the pod is created. Now let's check the pods in the default namespace. The pod name is am I ready? It's running. Let's now inspect the service and the endpoint. So previously, the service am I ready did not have any endpoints. It was none here. After scheduling the second pod, it should pick up the IP address of the second pod. Which we will see by executing kubectl get pods in the default namespace. Second pod name is am I ready, and let's use the override to print the IP address. So this is the IP address of the second pod, and this is now the endpoint for the service with the port number 80. Now the first pod should be in the ready state. Confirm that. Let's check the status of the first pod. First pod's name is this one, ready if service ready. Now, earlier it was 0 of 1, and now it is 1 of 1, which is a good indication. Kubectl describe the pod. So, it's running. Okay, no new events that is recorded, but yeah, the pod is in a running state. You can clearly see from under the ready state. So that's it for this question. Thank you.